out, sister. Ah, okay, I can't dance, y'all know me. But today we are going to, I'm sorry, to my recurring subscribers, I want to thank all 72.
And we're actually at 83 subscribers right now. So, my bad.
Of you guys for sticking with me, continuously watching my videos, sharing, liking, subscribing, everything. It means a lot. Please continue to share, subscribe. Help sister out. All right, let's get to this video. So, today we are going to be making a staple, which is salmon cakes. Salmon cakes, salmon croquettes. Whichever you want to call it, whatever. But it's one of those hood, you know, some salmon cakes, yeah. So today I decided, I make these a lot, but today I decided I was going to show you guys how I make them. So if you want to see how I make them with the little sauce that I make to go with them and everything like that, stay tuned and keep on watching. First, I'm going to wash my hands, of course, because a bunch of COVID and all that stuff out there. You want to be washing, you know, cooking no dirty hands. But we're going to open this can, take all the bones. Yes, they're all bones of you, duh. Take all the bones out of here. I'm going to place my bones in this bowl and I'm going to place my salmon in this bowl. So that's what you guys are going to watch me do right now. I don't need to talk y'all through that. You know, I'll just show y'all. Make me feel like this is life worth living. Make me feel alive, oh yeah. Tell me how my side. So what I'm going to do first is I'm going to drain all of the excess water or salmon juice or whatever is that's up in there. And I'm going to drain that really good. And now we're going to take the bones out. Kind of just clean the whole piece take the whole piece out of the can, clean it, all of the skin or anything, you know, that I'm not going to be using, bones and everything like that, I take that out, clean that off of it, and then I split it in half. Well, I, not split it in half. Then I open it to the middle, and boom, there you go. And you should be able to get everything out of there like that. So I'm going to do this, go ahead and do this second can. And tip, if you do not want to smell, you know, your house smelling like salmon, then rinse the can out before you throw it away. You know? Like so. So again, I'm going to take the whole. And it looks so weird. Oh my goodness. But yeah, it's gonna be so good. So, just wanna take the entire, clean off the rim, well, the outer part of the whole piece. This skin out of there. And as you can see, I'm like feeling through the salmon as I am removing the bones and the, sorry guys, I'm concentrating. But as I'm removing the bones and the skin, I am feeling through the salmon to make sure that I don't leave any bones in it. And whenever I feel like a little piece that seems like it's already good, it doesn't have no bones on it or in it or anything like that, I'll go ahead and see like this, right? I'll go ahead and drop that right in there and feel through it as I'm dropping it in there. So, here we go. Boom. If you can see what I'm talking about, I hope that was close enough. So I'll just take this whole piece out. That was all bone. I don't know if that's the spine or what. I really need to look that up. Looks like that's what it is. So now I'm just getting all of the excess skin, everything like that off of there. And feel through it. Feel through it. I love salmon. Oh my goodness. It smells so good already. Don't judge me. I truly love salmon. I swear. It's like number one. Any fish, you know what I mean? We talking fish. Salmon's number one. Seriously. Uh-oh. You guys know what I never did? I never fried any salmon. My sister did. What was that, for New Year's? And it was so good, oh my goodness. It was so damn good. So I have to try that. So now I'm just feeling through just to make sure I didn't forget anything. And boom, there you have it. All separated, bones are out, nice and clean, ready to go. guys, as you can see, I have my salmon separated from the nasty bones, all of that skin, all that stuff you don't want in your salmon cakes. And here I have the cleaned salmon ready to use. So I can go ahead and throw this away and we're gonna work on this. So first things first, you guys want to get your vegetables or whatever it is you place inside of your salmon cakes, or you would like to place inside your salmon cakes. Some people use green onions. Sometimes I do. If I have it on hand, I don't have any. Some people use fresh parsley. You know, it's whatever you prefer, I guess. And these are my ingredients I'm going to be using today. The green pepper, the red pepper, and the onion. So we're gonna chop that, dice that up into small pieces, and we'll be right back. Up on a little secret. So if you just watched me get that glass of water, the ice water there, this helps with your eyes getting really watery when you're cutting a onion. Okay, thank you later. Vegetables chopped and cut, ready to go. So these are the vegetables I'm using: onion, chopped green pepper, and chopped red pepper. So guys, I'm going to be seasoning with the Tony Sachet's famous Creole seasoning, no salt. I'm going to be using smoked paprika. I'm going to use a little thyme, garlic powder, onion powder, a little obey, and of course some black pepper. For me, anyway, that's how I do mine. Feel free to do it how you do it, but we're gonna use one. So guys, one of my ingredients that I like to use are Ritz crackers. I do not use breadcrumbs, so that's one of my secrets, I guess, to my salmon cakes, is that I don't use breadcrumbs. So for two cans, I should only need this whole pack here. So what I'm gonna do is I'm gonna crush these into my bowl. And I just use my hands, clean hands, of course.
And if you be cooking for real, you know that your hands are the best tools in the kitchen.
mayonnaise. This is the only mayonnaise I use.
Just a few scoops of that, and you can always add more later, but you can't take away, so start with a little.
I'm also going to be using some W sauce or Worcestershire sauce. Just a few drops of that. And now I have my chopped vegetables that I'm going to be using. I'm going to throw these in there.
And now we're going to give everything a mix. And there you have it. And as you can see, I had to add maybe about 5 to 6 more crackers. But yeah, there you have it.
So now that my salmon is mixed up, I am going to start forming them into patties so that I can cook them. So first, of course, I'm going to wash my hands. And I just have here a piece of foil that I'm going to lay them on as I create the patties. So here we go. But here are the patties that I have done so far. There's more, but yeah. So you just want to shape them just like this, and we'll be back.
Add your oil to your pan.
Now that your grease is nice and hot, you see it popping because I had to check to make sure that it's hot. Hopefully, don't pop on my end. Look, I'm loving it. Okay, but no, okay. Let's go. I am going to now add my patties.
At my personality, just goofy all day every day, child. Look at those salmon cakes after I flipped them. So I'm just placing them on a cooling rack now to drain the excess oil. And now for the sauce. I'm going to be using some Dijon mustard. I'm also going to be using some horseradish mustard. Some people use horseradish, but I don't like horseradish, so yeah. I'm going to be using some honey. I'm going to be using some garlic powder, some obey, some onion powder, some black pepper, of course, ketchup, the no salt Cajun seasoning, my mayonnaise, and some relish, sweet relish, of course. Add in a few scoops of that mayo. the horseradish mustard, Dijon mustard, and relish. Add your honey, ketchup, your seasonings, and give it a mix. Add you some lemon juice up in there and mix it again. And there you have it, guys. My salmon cakes came out so good. I added some lemon slices to the side to make it real cute, whatever. That sauce and stuff, and child, I was ready to eat, okay?
All right, my buns and beauties, that's it for today's video. Here are my salmon cakes. They came out so good. I don't know if it's all for today, but they came out so good. Can't wait to dig in. So I hope you guys enjoyed this video. I hope you guys picked up something off of this recipe. If you try it, let me know in the comments how it turned out. And I'll see you guys in the next video. Bye.